This is Realm of Dragons, Age of the Sorcerers, Book 1. Written by Morgan Rice. Narrated by Kevin E. Green. Chapter 1. King Godwin III of the Northern Realm had seen many things in his time. He'd seen the march of armies and the working of magic, but he could only stare at the body of the creature that lay before him, prostrate and unmoving on the grass, its bones and its scales lending a sense of impossibility to the moment in the evening light. The king dismounted his horse, which was refusing to get any closer, whether because of what the creature was or simply where they were. They'd ridden more than a day south of Royalsport, so that the roar of the Slate River was just a few dozen yards away, the ground of his kingdom dropping away into those roaring, steely, violent waters. Beyond it, there might be watchers, staring out from the south, even across its vast width. Godwin hoped not, and not just because he and the others were so far from home, open to any who could get over the bridges between the kingdoms. He didn't want them seeing this. King Godwin stepped forward, while around him the small crowd that had come with him tried to work out whether they should do the same. There weren't many of them, because this wasn't something he was sure he wanted people to see. His eldest son, Rodri, was there, 23 and looking like the man Godwin had once been, tall and powerfully built, with light hair shaved at the temples so that it wouldn't obscure his swordsmanship, in the one reminder of his mother. His brothers, Vars and Grieve, were still at home, neither the kind of man to ride out on something like this. Vars would probably complain that Rodri had been chosen for this, but would not volunteer for something with a hint of danger. Grieve would be stuck in the library with his books. His daughters were frankly more likely to have come, or at least two of them were. The youngest, Erin, would have relished the adventure. Nera would have wanted to see the strangeness of the creature, probably cried over its death in spite of what it was. Godwin smiled at the thought of her kindness, although as always that smile faded slightly at the thought of her latest coughing fit, and of the sickness that they kept so carefully concealed. Leonore would probably have preferred to stay in the castle, but then she had a wedding to prepare for. Instead of any of the others, it was Godwin and Rodri. There were half a dozen knights of the Spur with him, Lars and Boris, Halfin and Twell, Ursus and Jorin, all men Godwin trusted, who had served him well for decades in some cases, their armour embossed with the symbols they'd chosen, shining slightly in the spray from the river. There were the villagers who had found this thing, and there, on a sickly-looking horse, was the robed figure of his sorcerer.
"Grey,"
King Godwin said, waving the man forward. Master Grey stepped forward slowly, leaning on his staff. In other circumstances, King Godwin would have laughed at the contrast between them. Grey was slender and shaven-headed, skin so pale it almost matched his name, with robes of white and gold. Godwin was larger, broad-shouldered and frankly broad-bellied these days, armoured and full-bearded, with dark hair down to his shoulders.
"Do you think they're lying about this?"
King Godwin said with a jerk of his head toward the villagers. Godwin knew the way his men tried, with cowbones and leather plates, but his sorcerer hadn't answered his question. But Grey merely shook his head and looked him straight in the eye. A shiver ran up Godwin's spine. There was no doubting the realness of this. This wasn't some joke, to try and gain favour or money, or both. This was a dragon. Its scales were the red of blood poured over rusted iron. Its teeth were like ivory, as long as a man was tall, and its claws were razor-edged. Great wings spread out, ragged and torn through, huge and bat-like, seeming barely enough to hold such a great beast aloft. The creature's body curled there on the ground, longer than a dozen horses, large enough that in life it could have lifted Godwin like a toy.
"I've never seen one before,"
King Godwin admitted, placing a hand against the scaled hide. He half expected it to be warm, but instead it was only the cold stillness of death.
"Few have," Grey said.
Where Godwin's voice was a deep, sonorous thing, Grey's was like a whisper of paper. The king nodded. Of course the sorcerer wouldn't say all that he knew. It wasn't a thought that comforted him. to see a dragon now, and a dead one.
What do we know about this one?
The king asked. He walked down the length of it to the remains of the tail which stretched.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.